Hello everyone, welcome to another session. In the last session we discussed a little bit about the topic percentage and we are continuing with that. So in this video we'll talk about further more questions, how we solve them, what are the shortcuts that we can apply and how we can get the correct answer with minimum effort. So let's start with first question which appeared in NIFT also. So this question came in NIFT 2022. In this it is said that a fruit seller had some apples. He sells 35% apples and still has 390 apples. Originally he had how many apples? So in this, let us directly look at the question. So that means he sold 35% of apples and the number given here is for the remaining apples. So if 35% is sold, what would be the percentage for remaining apples? That would be 65%. Now this 65 is equals to the 390 apples in number. So let us, if we assume the total number as x, so it would be 65% of x is equals to 390. So we can calculate x as 390 into 100 divided by 65. Now we can divide it by 5 each time and get to answer. But what you can do to improve your calculations, for example, here the options are given. So with this option, we know one thing, that either it would get divided something in between 5 or 6, right? Because everything is either 600 or 500. So it will divide it by 5 or 6. That then only the answer would come in between that. If we look at the first digits, 390 as 39 and 65 as 6. So 39, when we see divided by 6, it goes more than 6. So we can first try it by 6 by assuming from the given options. Because in options we get it very clear, either it will divide 390 by 5 or 6 or something in between, right? So let us try it with 6, because that is more probable, because 6 into 6 or 60 into 6 is 360, we know. So it is more than 360. So that is why we should try that one first. So let us first see what is 65 into 6. So it would be 390. So we directly reached, we know it would divide it by 6. So we reached 600. Now we can do it directly also. There is no problem or nothing wrong with that. But the point is, whatever time you can save in the examination, in every question, you will use it for the questions in which you will get stuck. The questions which are simple and straightforward, try to improve your calculations so that you save some seconds from that question. And that could be used in the questions where you have to apply your mind a little more in understanding what the question is about. Another question is of the same type. A bookstore sold 20% of the books and still have 640 books left. So it is pretty similar. Sold books are 20%. That means left books are 100 minus 20, that is 80%. Now again, this 80% must be equal to 640 because these many books are left. So 80% of x would be 640. So x would be 640 into 100 divided by 80. Now again, 8 8s are 64. So we'll get the answer as, 8. So we'll get the answer as 800. So let us move to the next question. Now you can pause this video and try to do this question. Fresh fruit contains 68% water and dry fruit contains 20% water. Now how much dry fruit can be obtained from 100 kg of fresh fruits? So in this, there are two things. One is water or fruit content. Another one is water. So either there is particular amount of water in a fruit and particular amount of fruit itself, like pulp. So we can divide it like that. So a fresh fruit, you must have noticed it by yourself. When we eat a fresh fruit, there is a lot of water inside it. So pulp is less, water is more. And when we see the case of dry fruits, water content is very, very less. It's only pulp kind of a thing, right? So they are asking how much fruit can be obtained from these many fresh fruits, dry fruits can be obtained. So if we have to see what can we equate, the water in this case? No, because water content would be different. But the pulp content would be same. For example, if there is a fruit, it is fresh right now. It has some water, it has some pulp. When we dry this fruit, when it becomes a dry fruit, then what gets removed? The water gets removed, right? Fruit pulp, which was inside the fresh fruit, would still be here. What the thing that has gone out or gone away is water. That means it is clear that we have to equate the pulp of the fruit. Keeping this in mind, let us see. In fresh fruits, 68% is water. That means 32% is pulp. Now they are asking, how much dry fruit can be obtained from 100 kg of fresh fruits? So first let us see how much pulp can we get from 100 kg. So that means 32% of 100 kg. So it would be 32 kgs. This much pulp of fruit we will have from 100 kgs. Now let us see how much percentage of pulp is there in dry fruits. So dry fruits contain 20% water. That means 80% of pulp should be there. Now the total pulp is 32 kg. So that means 80% of the content of dry fruit should be equal to 32 kg, because pulp would be same, remaining would be water. So now we can calculate D, 32 into 100 by 80. Now this also, these things you should know, 80% means 4 by 5. So that also you can directly apply. Otherwise, it will come as that only. So we will get the answer 40 kgs. So I hope you will try these methods, and I hope you will do more questions at home. But for this video, let me know how you found it, and also tell us whether you want these type of videos to continue, because we'll cover the whole syllabus one by one like this. I hope you like the video. Thank you so much.